Hello there guys, welcome back to my channel. We have Law by Alexandra Bracken. So this is a book we got in Fairyloot, I believe the January book. Yes, January 2000 book, 2021, this month, this year's mean. Finally getting some more through the books this year. So this is the book that they designed, and I love this series. Oh, I love mythology, I love the books. So, the games have begun and she's paying for her life. This was some intriguing stuff. So this is the front, we have the back of his spine, and then we have this, hunt or be hunted. That's so cool. And then we have our spines, which have like this snake on it, and stuff like that, with yellow sprayed edges. Ouch. We have this salt, the symbol of Medusa's symbol on it. And then we have, we have this on the spine, which I find really cool. And then on the back, we have this symbol too, which must be the back of the thing as well. And then we have this. Our artwork on the reverse dust jacket, which I do love when they do this, and it's very, very pretty. So, in the modern day, New York, a murderous game is about to begin. The Argon. Every 7 years, for 1 week only, Zeus punishes the gods by forcing them to walk the earth as mortals. Savagely hunted by descendants of ancient bloodlines, all eager to kill God and seize their divine power and immortality. After her family was brutally murdered by the rival line, Perseus fled, turning her back on the Argon's cruel promises of eternal glory. For years, Law has honoured her parents' memory for doing one thing, surviving. For this year, she has pushed away dark thoughts of revenge until now. The next game dawns, Law finds Athena gravely wounded on her doorstep. The goddess offers her alliance against their mutual enemy, and a way to leave Argon behind forever. But Law's decision to rejoin the hunt will come at a deadly cost, and may not be enough to stop the rise of a new god, with the power to destroy all humanity. So, it is signed by the author. As well, so we have a map, which let me turn it this way, so it kind of gives you like different measurements of places that shows actual places of them, which I find actually really cool. Then we have gods, so they showed us a bit of the gods. We have the living lines, we have the house of Candmos, we have the house of Asidius, the house of Theus, the house of Archives, the house of Pursuits, the house of Malagum, sorry if I'm saying these names wrong, the house of Bellophon, the house of Jason, the house of Holocaust. So you got, the house of Serpent, house of the Trojan Horse, house of the Minotaur, the house of the Warrior, house of the Gorgon, house of the Bull, house of the Pegasus, house of the Ram, the Nemelin Lion, and then we have this thing here. And it starts off. This book, guys, was amazing. I want to get more mythology books anyway, because I love mythology stuff anyway. So this was very good. And I love Percy Jackson, stuff like that as well. This was some good stuff. I know my fate, she whispered to him, and I'll change yours. Oh, so good. Change the fate designs. I'll tell you now, right? I never cease to amaze me with how well she wrote this book. I may not always entirely love the story, but writing wraps me up and it has me feeling throughout the entire span of this novel, right? This one in particular is not exactly what I hadn't expected, right? I was like, oh, this is mythology, I'm excited, but like, Now I forgot what I was going to do. Sorry, unless you like, So this one is all about Greek mythology and literally just an interesting thing to it. I didn't expect how like violent this was going to be, but I love the whole series, the summary to it all. The other thing that I wasn't picturing everything wrapped in my head so neatly, so every time I'm trying to figure it out altogether, I was like, I'm not sure how to actually pull it in my head kind of seriously, you know, when you like watching you're reading your series and you're like, how can I picture this in my head when you can't picture it yourself, right? Is that just me? Probably not. So it's been a while since I've wanted to get to this book, like read a quite a mythology book. It's filled with powerful characters. Oh, that reminds me, I have got some Percy Jackson series and I've put it down in a box because I was going to read them next year, but now I can read them this year. So this has breathtaking magic and an epic adventure. What's to doubt the most about lore was a seamless and engineering combination of immortal and mortal worlds. Lore takes place in a modern-day New York City, and the constant mention of technology and the landmarks, don't let that forget. So the technology mechanisms like drones, iPhone, local tracking, and stuff like that. Lore's a Percy Jackson meets Hunger Games. That's definitely exactly like that. That is dead on how to explain it. You get a fix of bloodthirsty Greek gods and the endless airs of drama. And you also get action-packed competition. So this Argon bot forces Greek gods to head down to Earth as mortal for 1 week. Hunters attempt to kill a god to take their powers. Since I'm not really a regular person who normally would read these, I got this done in literally maybe a day or so. Because I literally just wanted to read it more and find out what the hell happens. It's also a darker page turner. It's a darker theme to quite a bit of violence. Definitely. This book has a lot to show with twists and turns and betrayals, so I'm definitely looking forward to reading more by the author. Lore is a book I won't soon forget, and I recommend to anyone who's looking for a brilliant way to escape to. I have seen that she has got other books that she has written, so I definitely want to have a look at those now, because this book was definitely intriguing to me to read. And I've got a hiccup, sorry. So I am looking forward to seeing what else she has to offer, and then read those. So thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys next time for the next book comes. Bye.